Back with another YouTube video. So I've sort of been absent, but hopefully I'll get that fixed. I've been under a lot of stress. Got a lot of shit going on at the moment. So I'm really just trying to get stuff done. I really don't know how I'm gonna get all this done, but I will. I got a lot of stuff to do, so I'm gonna try to balance everything out. But if I don't make videos, I'm sorry. That's really all I can say for now. But anyways, we are playing. As you can tell, we are playing Paragon. Game we haven't seen in a while on my channel, and we are going to be playing the support class Dekker. Let's go ahead and jump in. Player versus player. Alright, so with Paragon, I've had terrible luck trying to record. Terrible luck. For some reason, every time I try to record it, either there's something breaks at YouTube, my PlayStation wants to screw up, we lose the match in a horrific way, just whatever. But we're going to try. So moving into the game here, we have what looks to be an assassin on the far left. Next to him, I think that's either a fighter or a pusher, as Twin Blast, and me as Dekker for support, and then we have a carry as Murdoch, and we're searching for another person. So, for those of you who don't know who Dekker is, oh, Captain has disbanded the team. That's actually just fine, because we had not at all for a level one. We want, oh, two supports. I guess she's a pusher. No, she's a carry. A fighter. If Steel goes tank, we could win. I mean, we could still win if it is hybrid or DPS, but that's pushing it. Sup, little niggas, really? That's not even really, dude. We had no PC players, it looks like. This will be interesting. Alright, so who, if you're not familiar with Dekker, I'll tell you her whole little list here. Her passive is, whenever I cast an ability, I think everyone in the group either gets mana, or instead of using the whole mana cost, I take a little bit from everybody to summon my ability. Then you move into her first attack, which is square. You throw a purple ball that can bounce and can hit and stun an enemy if it hits a player. But you can also just do AoE damage, so on and so forth. Then you have her, what's this, square, circle? I think it's a circle. It's a stasis bubble. Here, we'll just do it like this, because she's a cat. I don't imagine her doing much damage. Lord's wand. So yeah, here we go. Stasis bubble, or stasis bomb. Bouncing bomb that deals 131.818 energy damage and stuns on direct hit. I need to go left wing. Slow bubble. AoE bubble that slows enemies and deals 78.939 energy damage once it pops. Containment field being her ultimate. Circular fence that lasts for 5 seconds and grants allies inside the field 250 shield. Energy orb being her basic attack. Ranged basic attack dealing 78.359 energy damage, and then rocket boot, directional leap that gives allies bonus movement speed and letting you hop in and out of areas. So my Dekker builds, I think it's probably pretty standard. They changed some of her abilities. Stasis bubble did not used to look like that. Or stasis bomb, I keep calling it bubble. Stasis bomb did not look like that. They actually did a lot of HUD graphic changes in the recent update they let out today, which is pretty cool, I guess. But back to what I was saying. My build is sort of, I guess, unique. I really don't know. It's a custom build, obviously. I always do my custom builds. And in addition to that, you're gonna see probably some interesting and weird way I play this game. But trust me, I play Dekker all the time. I'm actually really good at her, so you just gotta give it some time, and you will understand my method to my madness. Wow, they did some really weird HUD changes. Now the enemies on my map light up. Like the enemies, the creep wave, so they now sort of just light up. My phone just went off. I just got my phone under attack. Oh, please. Oh, you fucking just changed cameras. There you go. So why, I don't know why a support is soloing. I guess Grux isn't helping me out in lane. I'm gonna have my. Alright, this game's probably gonna go bad. It really will, because. I don't. Why do we have two mid? I guess they have two mid as well. I really need Grux in lane. I'm not gonna get any kind of. They're gonna be feeding off of me if I'm not careful. I won't be doing much creep damage at all, but I will be doing a lot of player damage, so that's really what matters, and I will be doing heavy, I'm a heavy support, I will be stopping these guys in their tracks. Okay. So I would read you the update list, but I don't have it with me. I'll probably do it at the end of the video, and read you what all the update is. And even if we lose this one, I'm going to share it on YouTube, just so you guys see the update, and so on and so forth. Murdoch will kill me if I don't get the fuck away and into the fight here, where my team is. He's gone. Yeah, he's gone. So, they added, looks like a new, UI to activating travel mode. It used to be a car, now it is looks like a little ring around my cursor, which is actually really cool. I really do like that new style they added. Whenever you level up, either card XP or normal XP has like a new particle effect on your bar there. Oh, Muriel on Muriel action. So I need to be careful here, they might go for a gank. Looks like a blue steel trying to come in for a gank. I think Smurf is probably gonna I'm gonna back off of them push. So those of you who are wondering, I think I mentioned this in the past Paragon video, but this game is not free to play, not until the beta comes out. Right now it's an alpha or pre-alpha, something like that, so you will have to pay at least $20 to get a code, not really a code, just access. But you can pay from anywhere to 20 to, it's over $100. I don't know if it's like 160, 190, I really don't know. It's crazy. And coming with that, you get a Founders Pack. They're all called Founders Pack. The one's called the Masters, stuff like that. The $20 one, which is what I bought, you get three skins for three different characters. You technically get one skin for each character. So you'll get one for Howitzer, Kalari, and Sparrow, I want to say. I'm really not 100% on those. Allied tower is under attack. But, what tower is under attack? Oh, right, so that's not being defended as well as I thought it would be. Anyways. You, getting the next set, the next Founders Pack gives you a lot more skins for a lot more characters, and then getting the ultimate one, the $100+ one, gives you a new skin for every hero, and future it gives you more skins for future heroes. So, is it worth spending over $100 more? I don't think so. $20 is just fine because you can do the master challenge for each individual character and get them playing the game. So, I don't know if I'd spend $100 this game. Sorry. I spent $100 on a lot of games, but it won't be this one. I gotta wait for this thing to push back out. Sorry if I sound like super, super weird or like drowsy. I just took a nap. I always take naps. It's been really drowsy here where I live. I'm not just sort of stay awake. And it was like really drowsy weather. I'm just tired. So I'm giving myself some just fucking pinging over here. Stop pinging at me. Fucking idiots, man. Really? You're just gonna keep pinging? You know, I gotta do nothing, I gotta say nothing, just keep pinging. I think it's actually my sister ward's picking up people. Yeah, okay. So, it looks like they now added maybe the update, they added alert effects for your sentry wards to help you know when someone's coming up on you, which is actually pretty cool. I think Howitzer is back here trying to, yeah, set up a harvester. Let's say you got it set up. I was trying to get a cheap shot off and hit him. So let's see, we have an enemy over here. There's Murdoch. Alright, so it wasn't someone pinging at me. Yeah, I know now. It was just my sentry ward's pinging. That's actually really cool that they added that, though. Go ahead and call for some help. Maybe I can get a gun. A gank. Looks like Steel is going to rescue. Can I engage? Yep, engage is up. I'm rushing in. Drop his back, drop him in, we're in. Just against him. Range and used to hit him. Nice. I was gonna commentate that fight, but I really was really just too focused on trying to get the kill done. Generally I commentate this game. I think you guys fairly understood what was happening there, to be honest. So I'm not making much lane push. I am not a pusher technically. I'm just a support. I could push, but I don't build my class like that. I build my class as heavy support. So throw to try and keep them off the tower. Alright, let's keep on moving here. Don't get pinged out of here. No man, you guys are fucking up here. I'll take the damage, bitch. Take the damage. There we go. Teleport back. I need some stuff. I really do like this new animation they got for teleporting in fast travel mode. Really like that little little cone animation going around the screen there. That's really cool. Put my staff on. My Elder Mage amulet. I might add Nature's Muse. This is actually a really cool buff, but that'll be more of an in-game item. I don't see me adding it right now. So, let's see. So those of you, yes, I do buy my items first and then buy upgrades for them. Why? Because the method to this madness is that, in my head, now that I have all my items set up, all I have to do is buy upgrades. So, I can, in my head, I can see everything I need. I know what's going on with my items, I know what items need what, where they are. It's just for me, personally. You can't always buy the items and upgrade them, so like 3, 6, 9, 12. I could have leveled up one item, and I would have had the buff. But this is actually giving me multiple buffs from all my items, where is leveling up one at a time would have given only me one item with one buff, and that's not really. I knew he was coming behind. I knew it so hard. I love that fucking war. That was amazing. Shoot my ward off. Pull him, Grux, pull him, Grux, pull him, Grux. I was trying to make some points. Oh fuck, he's going in. He's going in. I need help. I'm being attacked. I'm about to die from the tower. This guy's an asshole. He can barely reach me. Fucking book it. Murdoch. Oh, if I get fucking sniped. If I get sniped. Oh my fucking god. I'm waiting for him to line up the shot. Nope, I don't think he's gonna do it. Then we're clear. So with Murloc, you can actually, shoot through any walls. You can hit anyone from anywhere from the map. So if you play as Murloc, and you're trying to get some heavy kills, just snipe through the fucking mountains and you'll kill somebody. Little tip on him. Alright, so... looks like my my wards are pinging over there. Looks like two enemies. I am actually liking these sentry ward pings. Actually really helpful. Now that they're not annoying the hell out of me. So looks like equal damage done to the towers. Stasis bubble there. I wish I pushed the fucking plane, dude. Easy to go for howitzer. I'm gonna see if I can get the support on him. Go push mid. Alrighty, six bubble. Still get mid. So we're going for a... this is actually really, really, really risky for Rux, but with help, I think we can get him. We're not...
now that tower is up for attack.
We need to take the tower, then. Here we go. I will probably be making another video for this one, though. On Gideon, actually, Gideon now. Really needed a pusher. So this is my main support. Then I have a pusher. Then I have a carry. My carry is being Murdoch. My support being this character. My tank being Rampage, and my pusher being Gideon. So there's that. So put another bubble there to protect us from Murdoch's shots there. Not a bad idea, especially when you're fighting a Murdoch with a sniper. That can really save a teammate's life as long as you're. So you guys play that character. And, yeah. Remember that. There you go, put that bubble. We're taking this tower and we're gonna push him back. Go ahead and move him up a little bit just to give us some breathing room. Down, small explosion. Pitch up a steal here and go to the middle fight. We gotta fight in your prime. There we go, there we go. Nero taking out Howitzer. Oh, but Fengmei taking out Grux. What I might start doing now is play the game. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. You've gotta be kidding me. You've got to be kidding me. Did not mean to do that. So I might start playing the games now and then just do like some stuff. So I want cooldown reduction. Is this... Oh wow, this is also showing us the increase. The increase of our items. What our items are doing to us. So, looking at my... I just added cooldown reduction, so we find cooldown reduction. Where's that? Do they not have it anymore? Oh wait, scrolls down. Okay. Cooldown reduction at 20%. So that's pretty nice. I always take it to 30, then I do the rest with like mana and damage. So you will see that later in this game, hopefully. This is actually a pretty good game. 10-10, 9-10. They do have less kills than us, which is really good. More deaths. Looks like we have more assists as well. Me being primary of 4. That's not bad. Doing my job as a support. The more assists I do, the better I do. So, that's kind of how you play support. You're the assistant. You're the one who just helps the team. Whereas everyone else can, you know, get kills and everything, so on and so forth. I'm surprised Gideon has not pushed this tower yet. Him being such a heavy pusher, with all his AoE abilities, he should have pushed this tower a long time ago. Well, I guess it would just depend on who he was playing with. If he was on the spare, I don't see it. Oh, Howitzer got away. Play some Sentry Wards, give us some cover. No one knows who's on that left side there. There too. There we go. So now anyone in the middle should be able to... Yep, boom, got him. Got him. Nice. Look at my ward placement on point. Placing that down to get blue out, I don't want to get too much damage back. I want him up as low as possible. I was gonna place the chain up there, but I'm not gonna be definitely third-person MOBA game, this definitely has what you want. This game is fucking awesome. So for a third-person MOBA, like, honestly, I prefer this over Smite. Although I did rant about the card XP thing, I didn't like that, but I would prefer this over Smite. Smite's too unrealistic to me. Sorry, Smite. Then we're gonna go here, we need the mana. So now going over to mana regen, almost pretty good there. Max mana is 807, you can see we have way more. Cooldown reduction almost at max, it looks like. I don't know if it actually has a max. I think it's just sort of there. I think that bar is just an increase bar and how much you've actually increased that stat. I don't think it actually shows a maximum. What are these enemies? Oh, they're so just real quick, I will do it mid-game. We'll do a recap mid-game. This is not technically mid-game, it's still technically early game. Mid-game really won't be too late. Right tower. Alrighty, all that done. Calling for defend right lane. So is Grux, and so is... Oh, mean Grux. Telling him my way as well. Everybody disappear, which give at least suspicion, but howitzer won't get away. Unless, like, oh, no, he did. If he had not saw that we all had disappeared, he would have not gotten away. Someone's caught in the middle, looks like. Looks like Fang is chasing somebody. Is Blue being chased? Oh, we fight, we gotta fight. Shut off, boom. Job and grab this. Oh, shit.
There we go. Tower is under attack. Your power grows.
Muriel here, we can actually know what we're saying. Oh, this is way back to the top. Oh no, he snapped it. That's cheesy though, man. They really should not let Murdoch do that. That's gonna lose. Looks like Grux to be taking the mid. Let's actually go to the fight that was happening earlier. That's what he's doing our steal at him. Looks like they're just running around at the moment.
Enemy tower destroyed.
So he's just gonna get a Grux. Alrighty. So this game can either go away. Going to mid game, we rocking more deaths and kills. Well, even deaths, more kills, which is nice. Looking at tower vantage, they have one more tower than we do. Going into the assists, 19 to 11, pretty good. I'm liking that really. I have no idea what this column's for, to be honest. I have 43 of it. No idea. I will probably find out later. It doesn't really seem to me, to be honest. Walking here. Put these in the jungle for vision. Tank, steal, back up, please. Steal, please retreat. Thank you. Thank you so much for retreating. No, keep back. Oh,
moving, keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. Right, down a little bit. So we got a spare on the fight. Going on stone. Oh, this is pushing. Focus and bang. Push level up. Dodging it. I like the new helmet mission. Oh. Our team fights are not that good. We're not as strong as I thought we were. Although half our team is back down here. What are you guys doing back there? Oh, it's Muriel and Muriel actually. Why are you guys attacking an inhibitor? That's actually a stun. Doesn't matter, so I'm just gonna get away from it. Yeah, she has it. I can stun. I didn't put the containment from far enough to the left, they were actually able to break through.
An allied tower is under attack.
More mana. Thank you, that's maxed out. Now I need to do my either staff or amulet. So after that fight, looks like it's a tie game so far. They are down, almost down an inhibitor. We are still down one tower. We have three harvesters up. And no one's collected from the harvester. You guys do realize if you collect the harvester, we get more. So this guy, I'm on my way. How about Flayne? Yep, looks like Steels are trying to stop the creep wave. That's actually pretty good of him. We should push the tower over real quick. Grux, Muriel, me, and Steel. Yeah, this tower's fucking dead. I don't care how many people say it. They were gonna stop it. So it looks like we are now in the tower game. They have one left, so the inhibitor is dead. So this could be a surrender victory. I'm hoping it's not. Get a good job on Gideon, slowing us down. Fang Mage, shit. He's gone in blue. I don't know why. Name's Steel. If I say blue, I mean the big guy with the red armor. Orange armor, whatever it's called. He's on a blue because his skin tends to be blue in certain lighting. That's my bad. Having two supports really didn't help us this match, but I think we made it work. So we did a callback. No longer pushing there. That's actually really good. Going mid. Call for defend in middle. Hidden there now. I think Steel's staying back on right lane. I ran right past a harvester. I should go kill that. Bounce over there. Tower. There's no way I can take the Soul Creep wave. I would die so fast. I would need a lot of help. I'm not made to take out creepers. I'm made to take out all the made to take out people. I'm made to help people take out people. So as you can see, the lower I aim the cursor for my stun bomb, the better, less range, the better the stun. That's why I aim at my feet sometimes when I'm fighting creep waves. So now I have a choice. I can either buy Nature's Muse, which is actually a really good card, but I'll have no more credit. I'll have no more card points, which I have enough to get two upgrades in any of my cards there, any of my items. Or I can buy Nature's Muse, which is actually cool, and the fact that I can actually help out my team in a more supportive way. I really don't know what I'm going to do yet. I've never used Nature's Muse. I kind of want to figure out what to do. I can't get it off the time. Yep, down off the boom. Got it. And bring the thing down. We were getting that kill anyway. He was able to get away from Brux. He wasn't getting away from my bubble. We had him there. Muriel's not getting Grux, there's no way. No, with Grux and Sparrow there, yeah. Or Muriel and Sparrow, or Muriel and Grux there, yeah, there's no way. We're good. 10 points, C7, I'll have 3, I can upgrade one card. I can put one more point in the card if I want to use Nature's Mules. Muse. English. Core's exposed, is good. Gideon is from somewhere above us. Yeah, I was gonna work that. So, Nature's Muse. More mana, more health. More mana regen and a 5-second cooldown to all allies' ability. Pretty cool. I actually just want to try the card out. This match is going pretty well, so I'm going to try the card out. And I'm going to add mana for the actual ability. Hefty. I don't really want to worry about damage right now. Let's worry about getting my mana and such up. So we'll need. I'll put a perfect mana in, and then the next one I'll put a normal mana. Sparrow taking the tower. Grux runs forest. I think Sparrow has the most active camo, so we'll stick to her at the moment. Oh, Sparrow getting attacked. She's on the way. Oh, but she might get the. Oh, yeah. And we're back. We can now add in perfect mana, and then we'll add in a normal mana later. Wait, do we have another normal mana? Please tell me we have another normal mana. Okay, we do. We have one more. Alright, we're good. Oh yeah, her passive. Some mana used when casting ability is shared with nearby allies. So I think that means whenever I use an ability, my teammate gets mana. So I think that's what it means. I'm not 100%. I might put mana regen cards in this deck. I really don't know. I thought I had it in there, but they may have been for my Gideon deck. He did not know what hit him. How is this? Fucked all kinds of stuff. He was fucked five ways from Saturday. Oh, we're retreating? Okay. I don't know why we're not pushing core, but I guess it's fine. Unless we're gonna push right into it. Is that for me? Thank you. Blue buff, cooldown reduction, and energy regen. Booyah! That's awesome. Enemy harvest. Actually, I didn't think Steel would let me take that, but it's actually really good. But it makes more sense for me to take it than him. Ooh, is that 10-second cooldown? I got fucking nice. 6-second cooldown. So about the cool, I had made a video, but I don't think I have it anymore. I don't remember. There's a video where I said damage don't affect abilities. I've had two friends tell me now it does affect abilities, but we still aren't 100%. They were iffy about it, so we don't know if it does or doesn't. Give us the cooldowns. Also 2,000. So now we have the cooldowns and the extra mana regen. Cool for me. So I guess we'll do damage. Yeah. So can we even get 6 cards? 45 plus 6. I don't think we can get 6 cards. That sucks. No, we can go to 60. Yeah, we can. We can go to 60. Oh, my headset's about to die. Not good. So, Grux is teleporting back, let's see, we got Steel teleporting back, I think everybody's teleporting back. Yep, looks like everybody's teleporting back, so Spare is the only one being active, we will watch her for now. Alright, so late game, almost, when we get to 40 I'll say late game. No, get the...
Why are you attacking Orb Prime?
Why? That can cost us the game, why would you want to possibly cost us? Oh, and we get the surrender victory, hell yeah.
Booyah.
Booyah. So, doing late game, we went 19-18, following up with 11 assists. That is my job, holding the line with 11 assists as the most in the entire match. 19 kills, followed up with Grux holding the most, then going to Fang Mei and their team, which is really good. Good, really good fighters. Everyone's disconnected, so, except me and Gideon. And with 18 deaths, me being the most on our team, that's fine though, I was squishy. I did my job. Very well. I mean, I got 11 assists. That means we got, what was it, like 19 kills? That means like I was over half of those fights I was in. Oh, Paragon level 15. Earn an additional 100% reputation from your next 3 matches. Hell yeah. So we're gonna continue. And that was this video, guys. I appreciate you guys for watching, and I hope I can see you guys in the next one. Bye.